child was badly hurt today in a traffic accident on his way home from school. He was hit by a car while leaving the school bus. The car didn't stop while the bus was unloading. The driver knew better, but wasn't paying attention. Bobby knew better too, but ran when he should have walked and didn't look before crossing a busy street. There are dozens of students like Bobby every day who are careless around traffic, but who don't get hurt because drivers see them first. But sometimes someone gets hurt anyway. We are going to review safe practices for riding to and from school on a school bus. And we'll explain why your actions not only affect your safety, but the safety of others as well. Meet Mrs. Johnson, our bus driver. We have asked her and a group of her bus riders to demonstrate both the right way to ride on a bus and some of the wrong things that are dangerous. Driving a school bus is not an easy job. It is hard for two reasons. The bus is big and awkward, and it is full of often noisy students who can be very distracting. Your driver receives much special training before she is licensed to drive a school bus. She is taught about all the special controls and the skills in driving a bus that is so long and so wide. She goes to safety meetings with other drivers where she learns all the latest safety practices and how to handle emergencies. The bus driver's chief concern is your safety. But all her training will not help if the riders don't do their share, too. It only takes one student to make real trouble. Things that distract the driver can cause accidents. It is your job to see that you do nothing to make your driver look up from the road. Let's take a look at our school bus. Each one costs as much as four or five new cars. They are built to be strong and to last a long time. Your bus has seats which are comfortable but heavy enough to last many years if the riders take care of them. It has special lights for safety, and large heaters and fans to help keep you comfortable and to keep the windows clear on rainy days. It may have other safety features, like this mirror that shows the driver the front of the bus. And there is a crew of mechanics who work carefully to keep your bus running safely. Your school bus is one of the safest vehicles there is to ride in, if the riders observe good safety rules. There are several important points about getting on, riding, and getting off your bus that make your ride a safe one. Let's see how many of them you know. First, do you arrive at your bus stop on time? Having to hurry is dangerous. If you are late, you may make everyone late. Have you ever done this? You might startle the car's driver and cause an accident. Do you respect people's property who live near the bus stop? Damaging shrubbery or leaving litter makes your neighborhood ugly. Do you line up at your bus stop? Stand back a safe distance from the road. More children are injured in accidents while waiting at bus stops. As you walk along roads where there are no sidewalks or walkways, do you walk on the left-hand side facing the traffic? Do you walk in single file and as far off the road as you can get? This will make it possible for cars to go by quickly and safely. You must cross a very busy street to reach your bus stop. Do you wait for the cars to stop? If you run across before the bus arrives, you are taking a chance of being hit by a car. Finally, as you board the bus, do you use the handrail? It will help you to board faster and more easily. Let's review our safe boarding practices. First, be on time at the bus stop, not too early and not too late. Second, walk safely to the bus stop, facing the oncoming cars and off the road. Third, wait in an orderly manner, well back from the road. Fourth, have respect for people's property. Don't be a litter bug. Fifth, wait for the bus before crossing a busy street. And sixth, board the bus quickly using the handrail. There are several things to do to be a safe rider. How many of these do you know? First of all, do you stay in your seat so that you do not make the driver look at you? When driving the bus, where should the driver be looking, at you or at the road? Do you leave your bus as clean as you found it? Save your snacks and homework for later. Do you put books or bundles where they can't slide or fall, under the seat or in your lap? What's wrong with what this boy's doing? Do you talk quietly so that your driver can hear horns or other traffic sounds? Sometimes you need to carry large things on the bus. How can you do it and still be thoughtful of others? Do you remember not to stick things out the bus windows? What if his toy was his arm? Do you remember not to talk to your driver except in emergencies? Are you quiet when the bus is near a railroad crossing? The driver must be able to hear a train, even if it is some distance away. Do you know where the emergency doors are on your bus and how to operate the handle? You might need to use one sometime. The safe rider is one who is thoughtful of others and tries not to disturb the driver. Finally, how many of the safe practices for leaving the bus and for going home do you know? Do you stay in your seat until the bus is completely stopped? Do you take your turn? What happens when you crowd? When you leave, do you remember to take all of your things with you? Just like getting on the bus, do you use the handrail when getting off? And do you move away quickly from the bus? Crossing the road after getting off the bus is the most dangerous part of a bus trip. When you leave the bus, do you walk where the driver can see you? Are you sure the road is clear before you cross? Let's review our getting off procedures. First, we waited for our turn to get off. Then we moved quickly using the handrail. We moved away from the bus, crossed the street with care, and stayed off the roadway. We have reviewed the basic rules for a safe ride on your school bus. We explained how each of you can do his part to help the driver by not doing things which could cause accidents. We saw how we can act safely and still enjoy our rides to and from school. We saw how the bus is made to be safe. And we saw how the driver is trained to drive safely. Do you know how to be a safe rider?